Hello, my dear children. Today I am going to cover another session of class from the class 10 biology book of ICSE board. So, as I discussed in next earlier video about the cell and its functional unit of life, I hope it is clear to everyone. So, just like in previous video, I would like to teach you through the help of screen presentation, which will be much helpful to understand and will be much effective to you. So let's get started. So today, as you can see, the topic we will be discussing chromosome and its structure. So what does the chromosome means? And where do we find it? And the answer is, the chromosome is the thread-like structure of DNA and protein containing the genetic information, and it is found in the nucleus of the cell. So the chromosome was first discovered by the person named called Walter Fleming, and he discovered it in the 1882. And he found this chromosome in the larva of the salamander, and this chromosome looked like a colorful body, so because of it, it is known as chromosome. And the term chromosome was derived from the Greek word where the chroma means the color and the som means the body, which means that the color's body. Next one. General characteristics of chromosome. There are different characteristics of chromosome. Chromosome are made up of 30 to 40% of DNA, and the 30 to 40% of DNA, 50 to 65% of RNA, and 0 to 0.5% to 10% of protein, and it have the property of self duplication, which means it can duplicate into the sister chromatid and have the property of mutation, which means that it can change their genomic sequence. And next one is, it vary in shape, size and number in different species of plant and animals. Such as in human beings, there are 23 pairs of chromosomes, whereas in the rat there is 10 pair of chromosome, which means their number of chromosomes, shape and the size of the chromosome varies from one animal to different animal. And the chromosome are best visible in the metaphase stage of cell cycle. And next one, there are two types of chromosome, mainly autosomes and sex chromosome, which is also known as gonosomes. In human beings, there are 23 pairs of chromosome. In 23 pairs of chromosome, 22 are known as autosomes, and one pair of chromosome is known as sex chromosome. So what does the autosomes means? Autosomes are those chromosomes which carry genes for the character of hair color, skin color or eye color, so that character which carries genes is called as autosomes. And those chromosomes which included one pair of chromosome in human beings is known as sex chromosome, which is involved in the development of male or female gonads. The boy child and the girl child is determined by these sex chromosomes only. Next one, structure of chromosomes. this is the structures of chromosome. This part is the structure of the chromosome, in which this middle region is known as the centromere, which holds the spin. This middle layer is known as the centromere, which holds the spindle fiber and the arm of the chromatid. And this part is known as the arm of the chromatid. This part is known as centromere. And this, the terminal region of the chromosome. This end region. Terminal means the end region of the chromosome. This four end region of the chromosome is known as the telomere region. Telomere region, and this this small section of chromosome are shown in this small section of chromosome are shown in this picture, where this is in the condensed form. So I had told that the chromosome are made up of DNA, RNA, and protein. So this helical structure, which are present is known as the DNA, and this blue and green region are known as the RNA. This DNA and this blue and green region is known as the histone protein. So the last part of this topic is called the parts of chromosome, and I had discussed these parts of chromosome in the earlier slide also by showing the diagram. So let's learn these parts of chromosome again. So there are different parts of chromosomes, such as centromere, chromatid, chromomere, and telomere. And the centromere is nothing but it is a specialized DNA sequence of a chromosome, which links a pair of sister chromatid. So I'll draw the structure and explain you what is centromere. And my dear student, don't get confused that centromere is present in the middle of chromosome. So sometimes it present in the middle of this chromosome, but sometimes it can be present in the terminal side also. So let's draw the structure of chromosome once again. If this is the chromosome, so this part is known as the centromere. These are known as the and this is known as the sister chromatids, and with this the centromere join the sister chromatid. And if the shape of the chromosome is like this, then this there will be the centromere. And so the centromere does not present in the center always. And the next one is chromatid, and the chromatid, I had told you that chromatid is known as the arm of the chromosome. This is the chromatid, and this one is another chromatid. And there are two types of chromatid also. They are known as sister chromatids and non-sister chromatid. Non-sister chromatid are seen during the phase of mitosis, in cell cycle. I'll show the structure of chromosome during the mitosis stage. So let's look. This is the structure of chromosome during the mitosis stage. And at this phase, you can see the four chromatid, and these two chromatid is known as the sister chromatid. these two is known as the sister chromatid, and these two is known as the non-sister chromatid. Non-sister chromatid, and the last one is the third is the chromomere. Chromomere is a small bead-like structure in the chromosome. I had told you that chromosome is a thread-like structure, so this is some like chromosome. So in the chromosome there are bead-like structure, this like ball type of structure. So this bead-like structure is known as the chromomere, and the last one is telomere, and the telomere are those which are present in the terminal or proximal end of the chromosome. So if this is the chromosome, then this terminal region is known as the telomere region. So I hope you all understand this topic and enjoy it. So thank you.